Assalamu alaikum and good morning. Welcome to online session with revision class. That would be the continuity of the first class in which we discuss 20 multiple choice regarding parts of speech. So today we would proceed with 21. What are words, phrases, or clauses that provide descriptions in sentences? So, for option, modifiers. There are other option, verbs, positives, and object. So, phrases and clauses provide description in sentences. They are called modifiers. 22. What sentence clearly states a command or order towards another person or animal? You get the point. That is easy. Imperative, in which you give command. 23. Which sentence asks a question? And that's also quite easy. Interrogative or question sentence. 24. Which of these includes all the words in a clause or sentence except the subject and its modifiers? Complete predicate. So if there isn't any subject and modifier, is a complete predicate. 25. What part of a sentence follows modifiers or refers back to a direct object, that is object complement? So modifiers, sentence follow modifier or refer back to in a direct object, that's object complement. 26. What consists of a preposition and its object and modifiers? That is called prepositional phrase. 27. Which of these is not a modifier? So pronoun is not a modifier. Article can come, adjective can come, and adverb can come. 28. Which of these is not an adjective? So humility is a noun, it's not an adjective. 29. Which of these follows a linking verb and modifies the subject of the sentence? So predicate adjective follows a linking verb and modifies the subject of the sentence. 30. Which completes a linking verb and renames the subject? So predicate nominative completes a linking verb. 31. What is a noun or noun phrase that renames another noun right beside it? And we also discuss in the grammar a positive, which gives additional information to the noun or noun phrase. 32. Which of the following is a prepositional phrase? Talk silently near the gasoline station. So near, clearly you can see preposition near, so that's why it's called a prepositional phrase. 33. Which sentence contains an unexpressed subject? Unexpressed subject, not direct, like nail, come back here, not direct. 34. What is the unexpressed subject in imperative sentence? And it's always understood that imperative in command sentence, you is understood. Come here, stand up, keep quiet. So you is understood, although it is unexpressed. 35. Which part of speech may be used to describe or to modify a noun acting as direct object? Lazy. Because lazily is an adverb, slowly an adverb, consecutively is an adverb. So lazy remain the option which used to describe or modify a noun. 36. Which of these does not define a sentence? Focus upon not, does not. It means the other three would be include while only one would be exclude, and that is the first one. A sentence cannot be just a word. It is always a group of words. That does not define a sentence, while the rest of three can define a sentence. Like, a sentence contains both subject and a predicate. It's quite okay, the definition of a sentence. A sentence end with a question mark, an exclamation point or a period. They also define a sentence. And a sentence expresses a complete thought. That also is a complete definition of a sentence, while the first one cannot be, because it's not always a group of words. 37. Which of these is a sentence fragment? The boy near the pole. That is a fragment. 38. What is the verb in the sentence? Collected. It's easy. 39. Which specifies grammatical definiteness of a noun? So definite and indefinite article we have studied. So article specifies grammatical definiteness or indefiniteness. That is the function of an article in grammar. And 40th, which of the following is not a noun? Focus on not. Interesting is an adjective, bravery noun, gallant noun, sufficient noun. So interesting is not a noun. Thank you very much and have a nice day.